So guys, we're back up again with the live stream, the drawing. So what I decided was that, considering listening to people, getting feedback on the sort of concepts that I have right here that I was doing for my last video, I decided on going with this one right here, the first one. This is how I'm going to draw that as the actual cover. We're in the sketching process. I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing right, so on and so forth, so that's going to be fun. And I feel like I need to move this a little bit higher and make this a little bit smaller. Because if he's going to just be in the background, we can just have him about up here instead of where he's at right now. So we need to move this up a little bit. So about here. Yep. Because it'll cover the same amount of space. Plus, we'll get more X space here. Sit there. Plus, he's just going to be wearing a hood too, so it wouldn't matter too much. Let you go something.
Watch this short video.
Oh, we also need to erase that too. We found my need to erase before I really start going on this drawing. Well, if I really lost it, I'll be fine because I can see my other ones. Because I bought more than one, so I should be fine for the most part. Yeah. So it's no big if I really lost one. Hope that I didn't, though, but if I did, it's no biggie. No, yeah, I'm just gonna open the new one. Put this new needed eraser just in case. Yeah, but if we already have, if the one that we have, if we find that back here, we're just gonna come out with this new one, so. I really enjoy needed erasers because it doesn't matter how hard you draw pencil-wise on the paper, they erase real easily. It'll basically become barely noticeable. And since I'm going to actually be inking this piece too, probably for this video or the next one, that'd be dope. Since it'll be super easy to deal with. Okay, yep, so now we got a new kneaded eraser right here. Easy to tear apart and so on and so forth. Not like actually rip apart or anything, but like, you know, combine and so on and so forth. So that's cool. Actually, I need to move this old cover that I have up here. Excuse me. But, yeah. Let me adjust this back to all the way up here. Yep. Because the head's not going to be there now. Because we're moving this all the way up to the top. I was going to put this in the side perspective. Side profile, but it is. We're just going to move everything a little bit. See how far I can get this upward. Put my references too. Here we go. Rub this out a bit. Because if I'm basing this off of me, my jaw isn't like. My jaw isn't exactly like this. Well, kind of is to a certain extent. Because it basically just. Okay, let me pull up my actual photos. No, this will work. Yeah, this will definitely work, actually. So now that we have this, let's be careful too. We don't want to mess anything up. What are we doing? Can't forget, we're going to reference this concept of first one that we had because it's the most dynamic and so on and so forth. So let me erase this sketch at the bottom too. Okay, so you're standing there. So we're going to use our ruler too, for the most part, to make sure everything's correct. We could make those extra lines there if we really want to. I like actual random lines, but lines that make sense. Let's see what other side should be on. I'm going to erase that one too. Not done necessary, but until I try to angle it. No, I'm not gonna try to angle it. I'm gonna. Yeah, there goes that. All right, cool. So we're gonna actually draw what we were trying to draw earlier for the bottom part. We could even change it a little bit if you really want to. So, I'm thinking either something like this or something else. I don't know. I'll probably figure this out. Got the pectorals, actually. Thank you. No. The legs do not look right at all. To see his torso. Yeah, I'm about to fix this whole thing. So. Yep. Click on those two. Yep, click on the head, chest, shoulders, of course. Oh, what's up? Is everybody joining now for some reason? It's cool, thanks for doing it. Hopefully I'm doing this correctly. Because we have the head, the chest, torso. This torso right here. Let me actually try something out real quick. Grab some Procreate and then figure it out. regular size. Alright, give me a second. Actually, don't even have to do that pose. I can do a pose, any other pose really, to be honest with you, because this is just showing this character. So it's for the background. I can do whatever I want with. Yeah, I'm gonna change this pose. This looks too basic. I wanna do something actually dynamic. Well, it's already pretty dynamic anyways, but... okay. Now we're gonna erase that one more time. For a shortening, or we could try something different. I know we have that so far, so what type of pose do we want though for this? I'm trying to figure out more or less for the front view. Actually, since I do have a good photo of me standing, I can use that as reference anyways. That'd be way easier. So yeah, it won't look too bad then. Either way. That way. Oh yeah, we're gonna go back and use that same pose instead. I mean, but that could, I mean, but then I'm also thinking, like, and that'd be too basic. So we might want to add something interesting. I don't know. I'll have to figure that out. Looking at what dynamic pose that I could use. Basically, I need something for this bottom area. Because I'll also be adding stuff up here on the sides for the most part. But what? I know what I want to do, but I'm trying to figure out what would look the most interesting. Because if I had this in the background, that'd look dope to me. But like, does it make sense? Do you guys? Basically, I'm trying to figure out what to add in the foreground. Because this is essentially this thing, this head in the back, is going to be the character's, you know, alias, essentially. But I want this to be the main focus for that I'm going to be doing. And if I walk out of the city or something cool like that, basically something different is what I want to do for this. Or actually, if I want to, I could draw like demons or something like that too in the background coming up. So that'd be cool. Because I can make it super detailed now that I think about it as well if I do that. Because I was going to have it as other characters, but I could just have it be like, you know, something like shadow energy coming out from the character because he's using his abilities and swords affecting the actual pages, which is really dope now that I think about that too. So I'm going to add a pretty basic foreground like that. And my character show up and I'm going to add something super detailed. And then make it interesting in the foreground, but it's also going to be super detailed and interesting in the foreground. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Kind of stuff like this, I guess, more or less, too. That's what I'm thinking. Stuff like that, essentially. Where it's like I have a character, image of a character in the background, but then something super interesting in the foreground. But I want him actually displaying his powers in a dope way. If I just have him... I hope it makes sense of what I'm saying, though, guys. But I'm going to end this live stream and figure out what I want to do for the foreground. Thanks for everybody joining, though. I'll continue this later. Probably like 20 minutes or something like that. But yeah, please comment, like, share, subscribe. Kind of backer. And we'll be dropping more videos this week and the weeks to come. Thank you. We'll do another video ASAP once I figure out what I want to do for the foreground.